I am Rajesh, and this is my sign name. I have been working as a teacher of deaf children since the past 26 years. I prefer to sign, although I do use speech occasionally. I have noticed that speaking or mouthing words along with the signs, for example, pani or chai, makes communication easier. I started using drama as a technique for teaching my deaf students way back. I realized that making the classes funny worked well with the kids, and they seemed to really enjoy learning this way. Normal teachers discipline children way too often and end up diminishing their confidence levels. My students really liked me teaching this way, acting for them and joking with them. So this is how acting became my habit. It started at these schools. I did not know about deaf associations until 1997. My friend took me to an association, and it was a very small group of deaf people. We used to meet once a week and have a great time catching up with each other using sign language. Many of the individuals I found out had studied only till 4th or the 7th grade. I also noticed most were not able to read or understand texts, news, etc. independently. I went to a normal school and could read fairly well, so I started supporting the members by interpreting the news articles in sign language. They enjoyed this very much. Soon enough, I got acquainted with many other local deaf associations, few of which hosted drama competitions. I already had the experience of using drama with school children. Some of the deaf members at our association had great drama skills. Gradually, we made a team and started practicing together and began applying to these competitions. Soon, all the associations in Maharashtra came to know that the Dombivali Association drama team were a class apart, and our performances were winning multiple awards. Once, our team was requested not to participate, as the other teams were feeling underconfident because of us. We withdrew our participation, and I decided to support them with the stories. It was about then that I realized it was time to shift to films. The film industry is dominated by hearing artists. I am also aware about appropriation by hearing actors playing deaf instead of having a deaf artist play the role. There have been portrayals of deaf characters in some movies in the past. On one side, I am happy about the deaf roles, but not happy about the representation and authenticity. There was a deaf film crew in Bombay called Deaf Entertainment, and they were the first to host deaf film screenings. I was astonished to meet deaf actors. They were really talented and had a great turnout every film. I was really amazed because to me, they were the first deaf film team. I became a fan and used to go to their shows regularly. Seeing the Bombay scene inspired me to do something for the Thane crowd. However, there was one problem. Despite having the acting and scripting skills, I did not have the knowledge of editing and setup. This was something the Bombay crew had and I lacked. I had no option but to patiently keep at it. I think it was destiny that Hemang joined our association. During introductions, I found out that he worked as an editor. I was stunned. I learnt more about him. And finally, popped the question. Would he like to help edit my films? He said, of course, and wanted to join me. It was me and him, and we became a team. This was 2013. So I would film and record the scenes, and Hemang would do the editing. We were just starting, and you can understand the quality was average. However, I was so relieved that Hemang was capable of what he promised. We would make basic short films to use as pulse checks and float it among our deaf audience to see whether they liked it or not. This went on for a few years, and it wasn't until 2015 that we really came up with a great film. I created all the scenes, had discussions with Hemang about the flow and the cuts, etc. We actually made 4 such films to screen at the Deaf Film Festival in Maharashtra, where they were screening deaf films from all over India. All the 4 films were adjudged best films. We took home 4 awards. These awards helped us take root in the film scene. This was 2016. And we decided to take things forward in full steam. We regularly started pitching at film festivals hosted in different locations. In 2017 and again in 2018, we bagged the Best Film Awards. Meanwhile, the Bombay artists met us for support and guidance. They had lots of questions about our work and developments. This is when the team decided to book a hall for our first film festival. The hall charges were extremely high. We were very nervous as none of us could predict if the event would be a success. We had no experience of hosting such an event. We all had to invest our personal savings. Nevertheless, the hall was reserved and we went ahead with the plan. We were amazed that within a month all the seats were booked. This boosted our confidence and faith. We were on the right path. There was no looking back from there.